Hello friends, so in this video we are gonna learn a new concept called as Gauss-Seidel method. Now what is Gauss-Seidel method and why do we use Gauss-Seidel method? So whenever we have these simultaneous linear equations and whenever we want to find out the roots of the equation or the values of unknowns, then we solve it by many methods. So some of them are Cramer's rule, then you must have seen the method of Gauss elimination, the Gauss-Jordan method, then Jacobi's method. So these are the methods which are used to solve the simultaneous equation, and Gauss-Seidel is one of them. So by using Gauss-Seidel, we can definitely get the roots of simultaneous linear equations. Now what is this method? So this method is called as iterative method, and this method is also called as the modified Jacobi's method. So the rules of Jacobi's method are applicable here with certain modifications. So what are the modifications? So to understand it, we'll consider some simultaneous equations. So here I'll say let a1x plus b1y plus c1z is equal to d1, a2x now let's say we have three simultaneous equations with three unknowns. Now to get the roots of these three equations, if you'll observe, then coefficients a1, b2 and c3 will be large as compared to other coefficients of x, y and z. So if we want to solve this equation by Gauss-Seidel method, then we'll first of all represent these three equations in such a way that these large coefficients will go in the denominator. So see here how I am representing. So I'll represent this first equation as x equal to 1 upon a1 into d1 minus b1y minus c1z. So I'm taking this b1y and c1z on the other side, that will become negative, and this a1 which is multiplying x will go and divide there. Next, from second equation we have b2. So I'll say y is equal to 1 upon b2 into d2 minus a2x minus c2z, and z equal to 1 upon c3 into d3 minus a3x minus b3y. So here we'll get the value of x, y and z. Now to get the roots of the equation, we will use the method of iteration, because Gauss-Seidel method is the iterative method. So what is iterative method? So here we go through multiple iteration or multiple rounds, and we come closer to the roots. And once we get the desired accuracy of the root, that is our final answer, or that is the root of the equation. So to reach the desired accuracy or the proper root of this equation, we have to start with certain roots. So here we start with certain assumptions. So we say that initially the roots of the equation at 0, 0. So I'll assume that initial root of y and z as 0. So here in step number 3, I'll say put y0 equal to 0 and z0 also equal to 0. So by substituting it as 0, you will get x1 as d1 upon a1. So see, I'm starting with first iteration. So here the initial roots will be called as 0. Then the next roots will be called as 1, 1, that is x1, y1, z1, then x2, y2, z2, x3, y3, z3, and so on. So when y0 and z0 are 0, we are getting x1, that is the next iteration. So it will be d1 upon a1. Now, as soon as we get any new value, so this is the new value of x, in the next equation, we will use that new value. And this is the major difference between Gauss-Seidel method and Jacobi's method. So in Jacobi's method, what we do is we consider the initial roots as 0, 0 in case of y0, z0 and also for x0. So we consider all three roots as 0, then we find out x1, y1, z1 and we put it in the next iteration. But here in Gauss-Seidel, we just consider y0, z0, 0 and we find out the value of x1, and immediately in the next calculation we are gonna use the value of x1 here because x1 is the latest value, and z still we don't have latest value, so we will be using the same root of z0, that is 0. So we will get y1. As soon as we get y1, we will use that value of y1 in the next calculation. So here y1 is the latest value. Similarly, the latest value of x is x1, so I'll use x1 here, and we will get z1. So after the first iteration we will get x1, y1, z1. Now while going in the second iteration, we will find out the value of x2 by considering y1 and z1. Next, y2 by considering x2, because we got the recent or latest value of x as x2, so x2 and z1, and we'll go on. So by putting y0 equal to 0, z0 equal to 0, initially we will get value of x1. So here I'll say and find x1. Once you get x1, here I'll say put x1 and z0 here and get y1. Next, put the value of y1 and x1 and get z1. So this is the first iteration, and we'll continue this iteration till we get the desired accuracy. So whenever the values of two consecutive iterations are same, then that time we say that we got the desired accuracy and we stop the operation, and that is the value of x, y, z, or that is the required root of the equation. So to understand this concept, we will take one example. So the example is solve following equations by Gauss-Seidel method. So there are three equations, and if you'll observe, then see here, these coefficients are large as compared to other coefficients. So we'll convert these three equations in the form. So here I'll say let x is equal to 1 upon 27 85 minus 6y plus z, y is equal to 1 upon 15 72 minus 6x plus 2z, and z is equal to 1 upon 54 110 minus x minus y. Now here we got the value of x, y, z. Now we'll start with the iterations to get the roots or the values of x, y, and z. So we'll start with the first iteration. Here I'll say first iteration, and here we'll put y0 as 0 and z0 as 0. So by putting this over here, we will get x is equal to 85 upon 27, and I'll call it as x1. So it is 85 by 27. So in calculator, if you'll check, then the value will comes out to be 3.15. Now as we got the recent value of x as x1, we will use this value in the next calculation to find out y1. So the formula for y1 is 1 upon 15 72 minus 6 times x1 plus 2 times z0, because the recent value of z is z0. So z0 is 0. So we will get 1 by 15 72 minus 6 times x1. So here I'll say 1 by 15 72 minus 6 times x1, that is 3.15. And if you'll check this in calculator, then you'll get 3.54. So now this is the recent value of y1. So z1 is given by the formula 1 by 54 110 minus, now here I'll use the value of x1 and y1 because they are the recent value. So 110 by 54 minus x1 minus y1. So here I'll say 1 by 54 in bracket 110 minus x1, that is 3.15, minus y1, that is 3.54. Now if we'll calculate this value in calculator, then we will get it as 1.91. So now here we got the value of x1, y1, and z1. So we'll move to the second iteration. So second iteration is So in second iteration, we find the value of x2, y2 and z2. So if you'll see here, then to get the value of x2, we will need the value of y1 and z1, or the recent value of y and z. And here the recent value of y and z is y1, z1. So here this formula will be 1 by 27 into 85 minus 6 y1 plus z1, and it will become 1. Now if you calculate this in calculator, then we will get 2.43. Now let's find out the value of y2. So for y2, we'll consider latest value of x, that is the x2, and the value of z as z1. So here x2 and here z1. So we will get 2.43. Now if you calculate this in calculator then you'll get. Next, let's find out the value of z2. So z2 will be 1 by 54 110 minus, now recent value of x and y are x2, y2, we'll use it there. So z2 is 1.93. So here we got the value of x2, y2 and z2. Now we'll use this value in the next iteration. So here I'll say third iteration. So now for third iteration, we'll refer the equations. So to get the value of x3, we will use the latest value of y and z, and the latest value of y and z is y2 and z2. So this equation will be 1 by 27 85 minus 6 times y2 plus z2. So this will become
1 by 27 85 minus 6 times y2 plus z2. So this will become. Now if you calculate this in calculator then you'll get. Now let's find out the value of y3. So if you'll see here to get y3 we'll use the latest value of x and z. So the latest value of x is x3
and the latest value of z is z2. So I'll use value of x3 here and the value of z2 here. So we will get 3.57. Now let's find out z3. So here to get z3, we'll use the recent value of x and y, that is x3, y3, and we will get 1.93. Now if you'll compare this third iteration with second iteration, then value of z3 is 1.93. Whereas in second iteration, the value of z2 is also 1.93. Next, value of y2 is 3.57. Value of y3 is also 3.57. And value of x2 is 2.43. And value of x3 is 2.43. It means we are getting the same value in the consecutive iteration. So as I said, that whenever we get the desired level of accuracy, we stop and we call them as the roots. So here, our roots are x equal to 2.43, y is equal to 3.57, and z is equal to 1.93 for the given simultaneous equations. Thank you.